Hello students, once again I welcome to Trinity Matric online classes. In previous class we have to discuss about what is meaning pollination, what is cross pollination, what is self pollination, and how to take part pollination in spermatophytic plant, and what are the adaptation to carry out both self pollination and for cross pollination. Everything we have to detail discuss it. Okay, today we have to discuss about contrivances of cross pollination. Then contrivances of cross pollination means some mechanism or some devices which carry out that promote the cross pollination called contrivances. Okay, isn't it? Some mechanism or devices to carry out for cross pollination called contrivance of cross pollination. In generally takes place in two event. The first one is the dicliny or unisexuality. Dicliny or unisexuality. Then second one, monocliny or bisexuality. Monocliny or bisexuality. See that the first one, dicliny is, if it include monoecious plant and diecious plant. Dicliny which include monoecious plant and diecious plant. Then monoecious plant means, so the both male and female reproductive flower on found at the same plant is called monoecious. Male and female reproductive flower on the same plant called monoecious. Whereas diecious plant means both male and female flower are found in different plant is called a diecious. That means separate individual, this one same individual. That's all. See that example. So what are the monoecious example? See that coconut, neem, teak, etc., etc. So majority of the dicot woody plant has the monoecious. See that in this plant, except two, for castor and maize. Castor and maize. So the autogamy is prevented, but the gametogamy takes place. You know that what is autogamy? We have discussed in previous class what is autogamy and what is the for gametogamy. Generally, the unisex flowers is the mostly for self pollination takes place. But except for these two plants, for castor and maize, autogamy is prevented, but gametogamy takes place. Okay, come to the another one, diecious plant. For example, borosus, carica, papaya and date palm. Borosus means that is the palmyra palm. Some for plants means borosus means palmyra palm. Then second one, carica papaya. Carica papaya means papaya tree. Then third one, date palm. These are the examples of the diecious. That means the male and female plant is separate individual. That means for diecious plant. Here both autogamy and gametogamy is prevented. Both are prevented. Come to the for monoecious plant, in majority of the plants is the autogamy takes place, but some plants for but the gametogamy is the takes place. Then here except for two plants, castor and maize, the autogamy prevented and gametogamy takes place. See that here both autogamy and gametogamy both are prevented. Which one? Diecious plant. Okay. The next one, monocliny and bisexuality. Bisexual means, you know that the both male and female flower found and the same flower called a bisexual. So here the bisexual flower have the special adaptation to prevent self pollination. Having the special adaptation to prevent that self pollination. See that the further divided into four types. So monocliny or bisexuality, which includes dichogamy, first one dichogamy, then hercogamy, second one, third one heterostyly, and the last one or fourth one self sterility or self incompatibility. See that first one, dichogamy. Di means both two essential organ, androecium and gynoecium. So both anther and stigmas mature at a different time is called dichogamy. So the both reproductive organ, androecium and gynoecium, mature at a different time, not in same time. That is the different time is called a dichogamy. See that generally dichogamous flower are checking for self pollination, isn't it? generally dichogamy flowers for checking for self pollination. Then second one, herchogamy. Second one, herchogamy. In bisexual flowers, essential organ arranged in a such a way. This is one of the special type of adaptation. One of the such a way. Bisexual flower, essential organ arranged in a such a way. So, for example, anthocium and gynocium of the anther, stigmas, even style, everything we have to modify in different manner. That's all. See that, for example, Glorisa superba. It is a scientific name. Glorisa superba. For Tamil name is the Senkandal Malai. It is one of the state flower of our Tamil Nadu. It is one of the for state flower of Tamil Nadu. The Glorisa superba for Tamil Senkandal Malai. Second one, hibiscus. Both are example for the herchogamy. See that in Glorisa superba, the style is reflected away from the stamen. You know style, generally gynoecium consist of three parts, namely stigma, style and ovary. Stigma, style and ovary. Gynoecium is also called a, what is that? Pistil. See that. So, style is reflected away from the stamen. So, style is reflected away from the stamen. So, the style is arranged in the away from the stamens. See, the second one, hibiscus. You know that hibiscus, the common name or general name is hibiscus, is called shoe flower. What is that? Shoe flower. Here the stigma projected far above the stamens. Stigmas projected above the stamen. That is say both are the essential organ modified in a such a way. That is for the herchogamy special adaptation. Then third one, heterostyly. Hetero means the different kinds. That is the two or three different kinds of essential organ. That is means the heterostyle, different kinds of essential organ of stamen, style and stigma. That is the heterostyle. See that in some plants, two or three forms of flowers that are different length of stamens and style. That are different length of stamens and styles, but two or three forms, that is meaning hetero. Hetero means different kinds. Some plants having two or three kinds of different flowers. That three kinds of different flowers also, they have two different kinds of length of stamen, style and everything. See that here, one of the pollination takes place, but between the organ of the same length. See that in for heterostyly, so pollination takes place between the organ of the same length. How to length the same length of the, so what is the stalk of the anther? The phlegmon. So, the same length, it is the same length of the process, that is for heterostyle. And finally, fourth one, self-sterility or self-incompatibility. Self-sterility or self-incompatibility. Incompatibility means some plants not found to be the some process. See that. Some flowers, when pollen reaches on the same stigma, that is called a self-incompatibility or self-sterility. Some plants, when the pollen reaches are the same stigma the pollen reaches, that is for self incompatibility. Here, unable to germinate own stigma, that means unable to germinate in own stigma. In majority of the plants, the stamens are deposited on the stigma, but except a few, see here, unable to germinate the own stigma, that means for the self sterility. Okay. So generally the condiments of the four types are first one dichogamy, herchogamy, heterostyly and fourth one self-sterility or self-incompatibility. Okay students, next dichogamy is further divided into two types. So namely protoandry and the second one protogyny. Protoandry, then pro means before. So protoandry, that means so androecium is mature earlier than gynoecium. That means stamens are mature earlier than stigma. That is called protoandry. For example, Helianthus, then Clerotendrum, jasmine. For Helianthus, for English sunflower. Then second one Clerotendrum. Then third one jasmine. Clerotendrum means a woody ornamental plant. So these three examples are the protoandry. Then second one protogyny. For example, first one scarpularia. First one scarpularia. Second one aristolochia. and third one Asoha. These three are example for the protogyny. These two, so trichogamy, which include protandry and protogyny. Then protogyny means already, you know, I told. So the gynoecium is mature earlier than androecium. That means the stigma mature at earlier than stamens. So that is called protogyny. For example, scapularia, aristolochia, and Asoha. The next one, heterostyly, is further divided into two types. The first one, distyly and tristyly. Hetero means already told, two or three kinds of flower which united to form a special type of organ. See, first one, di means two. Di means two or bi. Then tri means three. Tri means three kinds of flower. See, first one, distyly, for example, primula. Example, primula. Here the plant produce two forms or two kinds of flower, that is called a distyly. Style means, you know, that style means that it is one of the parts of the gynoecium. Here plant produce two forms of flower. See, the first one, long style and long stigma, short stamen and small pollen grain. Here first one, two kinds of flowers produced. First plants produce long style, long stigma, short stamens and a small pollen grain will produced. The second one is short style, short stigma, long stamen and large or more number of pollen grain will produce. These two forms are which includes distyly. That means two kinds of flowers which produced. Then third one, distyly. Then for tri means three, for three forms. See, example, lythrum. Example, lythrum. Here for some three forms of plants produced. First one, long style. Second one, normal style. And third one, short style. Totally for three forms of the plants are produced. Long style, normal style and short style. Next, we have to discuss about agents of pollination. Generally, agents of pollination takes place in two types, that is abiotic factor and biotic factors. Especially agent means, what is agent? Especially for cross pollination takes place many or several agents, that is wind, water, etc., etc. So in cell pollination, need not essential for the agent. See, first one, so the agents of cross pollination is generally divided into two types. The first one, abiotic factor. The second one, biotic factor. So abiotic factor means that is a non-living factor. So pollination occurs in non-living things. The example, wind, water. So wind. So some pollination takes place by wind is called anemophily. Anemo means wind. Anemo means wind. Then pollination takes place by wind is called anemophily. You know, anemometer, how to wind velocity, we can measure how to wind velocity called anemometer. That's why, so anemo means wind. Second one, water. Pollination takes place by water is called hydrophily. Hydro means water. Hydro means water. Then pollination takes place by water is called hydrophily. These are all for some abiotic factors of the for some cross pollination. Second one, biotic factor. Next one, biotic factor. So biotic factor means so pollination takes place within the living organism. See that generally many type having. See, first one, zoophily. First one, zoophily. Second one, canthrophily. Third one, palynophily. And fourth one, melitophily. Fifth one, ornithophily. And sixth one, chiroptilophily. And seventh one, myrmecophily. Eighth one, entomophily. And finally, malcophily. See, first one, zoophily. Zoo means animals. Pollination takes place by animals called zoophily. Second one, canthrophily means pollination takes place by beetle. That is small beetle. That is having the many place. That is a beetle for takes place by pollination called further canthrophily. Third one, phalaenophily. Pollination takes place by moth. You know that moth. That is called for phalaenophily. And fourth one, melitophily. Some bees or honeybees, even honeybees also. So takes place by pollination called melitophily. And fifth one, ornithophily. So pollination takes place by birds. That is called ornithophily. Study about birds. You know that what is mean study about birds? Ornithology. Ornithology means a study about birds. That means ornitho means birds. Third one, chatrophily. So pollination takes place by bat. It is called a chatrophily. And next one, myrmecophily. Pollination which occur ant, because flowers having nectar, so so many ant and bees which attract that kind of nectars. So the pollination takes place by ant called a myrmecophily. And is the next one, entomophily. Pollination takes place by insect. Insect means entomophily. You know that what is mean by for entomology, study about insect called entomology. That's why entomo means insect. So pollination takes place by insect called entomophily. The next one, malcophily. Malcophily means pollination takes place by snail. That is called a malcophily. Okay students, for today we discussed for the agents of pollination, abiotic factor and biotic factor, everything occur. Then tomorrow we will see the detailed study of the wind pollinated flowers and water pollinated flowers. That's all.